From the Caribbean to the world, Jesus Christ is Lord.
Hey, good day. You're listening to Chronicles Christian Radio.
From the Caribbean to the world, Jesus Christ is Lord.
Worship the Lord, our Savior, Jesus Christ, on Chronicles Christian Radio, www.ccradio.co.
Get to heaven. I just want to make it in. Oh, I just want to cross that river.
Give me you. Worship.
Everything else can wait. Give me you. I hope I'm not too late.
Our God alone is great.
Holy, holy,
holy, holy, God Almighty, it's a privilege to worship you.
Worship.
I will be like my granddaddy one day. I'm gonna sing this song. It goes like this. Listen.
Holy fire, burn away my desire for that thing that is not.
Adore him.
You're listening to Chronicles Christian Radio.
Bible says, let everything that has breath praise the Lord. The Bible also says, oh, that men would praise the Lord for his wonderful works towards the children of men. And then the word confirms how God sends his word and he heals the sickness and the diseases of the people that cry unto him. The birds praise the Lord. The trees wave their limbs in celebration to the Lord. We praise the Lord on the instruments and on the drums and on the keyboard and on the bass guitar. But most of all, I believe what God truly desires is for our lives to praise him. So with this prayer tonight that we pray, that our lives be a life of praise unto the Lord. And we say, Lord, in everything that we do, in everything that we say, let our lives praise you.
Up no other person than Jesus Christ. Good morning to you. It is time to rise up in worship, rise up in praise, rise up in prayer, and most of all, rise up in Jesus. Welcome, my name is Venola Glasgow, and it's Rise Up with Venola. We give God thanks for the past hours of the night, for his goodness and his mercies towards us, for keeping us, and for bringing us to a brand new day. The psalmist says in Psalm 118 and verse 24, this is the day that the Lord has made, and we rejoice and we are glad in it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Pleasant morning to you. And I pray that as we go into the Word of God, as we spend time with our Lord and our Savior Jesus Christ, that you'll be revived, energized in the name of Jesus. And most of all, you would rise up out of your situation, whether good or bad, rise up and face a brand new day. Blessed be the Lamb of God. Blessed be the King of Kings, the conquering Lion of the tribe of Judah. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we give you thanks for a new day. Thank you for your mercies. Thank you, Lord God, that you saw it fit to keep us and protect us throughout the past hours of the night, and you brought us to a new day. And we say thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. For you are great. You are good. You are awesome and you are mighty. Lord God, as we spend time in your word, as we spend time listening to your word, reading your word, help us, oh Father God, to meditate upon it and to understand that you are with us and you are for us. We give you all thanks, honor, glory, and praise. Bless the hearts and the minds and the ears of the listeners, oh Father, in the name of Jesus. We give you all thanks. We honor you. We call you Lord. We worship you. In Jesus' name, we pray with thanksgiving. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord, for he delights when we praise him. He delights when we worship him. Blessed be the name of Jesus. This morning we're going to go into the book of Numbers 22, 23, and 24. And here we're going to see of the story of Balak the king and Balaam the prophet of God, and how Balak called Balaam to curse the children of Israel. And so now we go into our readings.
Numbers chapter 22. and the children of Israel set forward and pitched in the plains of Moab on this side Jordan by Jericho. And Balak the son of Zippor saw all that Israel had done to the Amorites. And Moab was sore afraid of the people, because they were many. And Moab was distressed because of the children of Israel. And Moab said unto the elders of Midian,
Now shall this company lick up all that are round about us, as the ox licketh up the grass of the field.
And Balak the son of Zippor was king of the Moabites at that time. He sent messengers therefore unto Balaam the son of Beor to Pethor, which is by the river of the land of the children of his people, to call him, saying,
Behold, there is a people come out from Egypt. Behold, they cover the face of the earth, and they abide over against me. Come now, therefore, I pray thee, curse me this people, for they are too mighty for me. Peradventure I shall prevail, that we may smite them, and that I may drive them out of the land. For I wot that he whom thou blessest is blessed, and he whom thou cursest is cursed.
And the elders of Moab and the elders of Midian departed with the rewards of divination in their hand. And they came unto Balaam, and spake unto him the words of Balak. And he said unto them,
Lodge here this night, and I will bring you word again, as the Lord shall speak unto me.
And the princes of Moab abode with Balaam. And God came unto Balaam and said,
What men are these with thee?
And Balaam said unto God,
Balak, the son of Zippor, king of Moab, hath sent unto me, saying, Behold, there is a people come out of Egypt, which covereth the face of the earth. Come now, curse me them. Peradventure I shall be able to overcome them and drive them out.
And God said unto Balaam,
Thou shalt not go with them. Thou shalt not curse the people, for they are blessed.
And Balaam rose up in the morning and said unto the princes of Balak,
Get you into your land, for the Lord refuseth to give me leave to go with you.
And the princes of Moab rose up, and they went unto Balak and said,
Balaam refuseth to come with us.
And Balak sent yet again princes more and more honorable than they. And they came to Balaam and said to him,
Thus saith Balak the son of Zippor, Let nothing, I pray thee, hinder thee from coming unto me. For I will promote thee unto very great honor, and I will do whatsoever thou sayest unto me. Come therefore, I pray thee, curse me this people.
And Balaam answered and said unto the servants of Balak,
If Balak would give me his house full of silver and gold, I cannot go beyond the word of the Lord my God to do less or more. Now therefore, I pray you, tarry ye also here this night, that I may know what the Lord will say unto me more.
And God came unto Balaam at night, and said unto him,
If the men come to call thee, rise up and go with them. But yet the word which I shall say unto thee, that shalt thou do.
And Balaam rose up in the morning, and saddled his ass, and went with the princes of Moab. And God's anger was kindled because he went, and the angel of the Lord stood in the way for an adversary against him. Now he was riding upon his ass, and his two servants were with him. And the ass saw the angel of the Lord standing in the way, and his sword drawn in his hand. And the ass turned aside out of the way and went into the field, and Balaam smote the ass to turn her into the way. But the angel of the Lord stood in a path of the vineyards, a wall being on this side and a wall on that side. And when the ass saw the angel of the Lord, she thrust herself into the wall and crushed Balaam's foot against the wall, and he smote her again. And the angel of the Lord went further and stood in a narrow place, where was no way to turn either to the right hand or to the left. And when the ass saw the angel of the Lord, she fell down under Balaam, and Balaam's anger was kindled, and he smote the ass with a staff. And the Lord opened the mouth of the ass, and she said unto Balaam,
Unto thee, that thou hast smitten me these three times.
And Balaam said unto the ass,
Because thou hast mocked me, I would there were a sword in my hand, for now would I kill thee.
And the ass said unto Balaam,
Balaam, am I not thine ass? ass upon which thou hast ridden ever since I was thine, unto this day? Was I ever wont to do so unto thee?
And he said,
Nay.
Then the Lord opened the eyes of Balaam, and he saw the angel of the Lord standing in the way, and his sword drawn in his hand, and he bowed down his head and fell flat on his face. And the angel of the Lord said unto him,
Wherefore hast thou smitten thine ass these three times? Behold, I went out to withstand thee, because thy way is perverse before me. And the ass saw me, and turned from me these three times, and lest she had turned from me, surely now also I had slain thee, and saved her alive.
And Balaam said unto the angel of the Lord,
I have sinned, for I knew not that thou stoodest in the way against me. Now therefore, if it displease thee, I will get me back again.
And the angel of the Lord said unto Balaam,
Go with the men, but only the word that I shall speak unto thee, that thou shalt speak.
So Balaam went with the princes of Balak. And when Balak heard that Balaam was come, he went out to meet him unto a city of Moab, which is in the border of Arnon, which is in the utmost coast. And Balak said unto Balaam,
Did I not earnestly send unto thee to call thee? Wherefore camest thou not unto me? Am I not able indeed to promote thee to honor?
And Balaam said unto Balak,
Lo, I am come unto thee. Have I now any power at all to say anything? The word that God putteth in my mouth, that shall I speak.
And Balaam went with Balak, and they came unto Kirjath-Huzoth. And Balak offered oxen and sheep, and sent to Balaam and to the princes that were with him. And it came to pass on the morrow, that Balak took Balaam, and brought him up into the high places of Baal, that thence he might see the utmost part of the people. Numbers chapter 23. And Balaam said unto Balak,
Build me here 7 altars, and prepare me here 7 oxen and 7 rams.
And Balak did as Balaam had spoken. And Balak and Balaam offered on every altar a bullock and a ram. And Balaam said unto Balak,
Stand by thy burnt offering, and I will go. Peradventure the Lord will come to meet me. And whatsoever he showeth me, I will tell thee.
And he went to an high place. And God met Balaam, and he said unto him,
I have prepared 7 altars, and I have offered upon every altar a bullock and a ram.
And the Lord put a word in Balaam's mouth and said,
Return unto Balak, and thus thou shalt speak.
And he returned unto him, and lo, he stood by his burnt sacrifice, he and all the princes of Moab. And he took up his parable and said,
Balak, the king of Moab, hath brought me from Aram, out of the mountains of the east, saying, Come, curse me Jacob, and come, defy Israel. How shall I curse whom God hath not cursed? Or how shall I defy whom the Lord hath not defied? For from the top of the rocks I see him, and from the hills I behold him. Lo, the people shall dwell alone, and shall not be reckoned among the nations. Who can count the dust of Jacob, and the number of the fourth part of Israel? Let me die the death of the righteous, and let my last end be like his.
And Balak said unto Balaam,
What hast thou done unto me? I took thee to curse mine enemies, and behold, thou hast blessed them altogether.
And he answered and said,
Must I not take heed to speak that which the Lord hath put in my mouth?
And Balak said unto him,
Come, I pray thee, with me unto another place, from whence thou mayest see them. Thou shalt see but the utmost part of them, and shalt not see them all, and curse me them from thence.
And he brought him into the field of Zophim, to the top of Pisgah, and built 7 altars, and offered a bullock and a ram on every altar. And he said unto Balak,
Stand here by thy burnt offering, while I meet the Lord yonder.
And the Lord met Balaam and put a word in his mouth and said,
Go again unto Balak and say thus.
And when he came to him, behold, he stood by his burnt offering and the princes of Moab with him. And Balak said unto him,
What hath the Lord spoken?
And he took up his parable and said,
Rise up, Balak, and hear. Hearken unto me, thou son of Zippor. God is not a man that he should lie, neither the son of man that he should repent. Hath he said, and shall he not do it? Or hath he spoken, and shall he not make it good? Behold, I have received commandment to bless, and he hath blessed, and I cannot reverse it. He hath not beheld iniquity in Jacob, neither hath he seen perverseness in Israel. The Lord his God is with him, and the shout of a king is among them. God brought them out of Egypt. He hath, as it were, the strength of an unicorn. Surely there is no enchantment against Jacob, neither is there any divination against Israel. According to this time, it shall be said of Jacob and of Israel, What hath God wrought? Behold, the people shall rise up as a great lion, and lift up himself as a young lion. He shall not lie down until he eat of the prey and drink the blood of the slain.
And Balak said unto Balaam,
Neither curse them at all, nor bless them at all.
But Balaam answered and said unto Balak,
Told not I thee, saying, All that the Lord speaketh, that I must do.
And Balak said unto Balaam,
Come, I pray thee, I will bring thee unto another place. Peradventure it will please God that thou mayest curse me them from thence.
And Balak brought Balaam unto the top of Peor that looketh toward Jeshimon. And Balaam said unto Balak,
Build me here 7 altars, and prepare me here 7 bullocks and 7 rams.
And Balak did as Balaam had said, and offered a bullock and a ram on every altar. Numbers chapter 24. And when Balaam saw that it pleased the Lord to bless Israel, he went not, as at other times, to seek for enchantments, but he set his face toward the wilderness. And Balaam lifted up his eyes, and he saw Israel abiding in his tents according to their tribes, and the Spirit of God came upon him. And he took up his parable and said,
Balaam the son of Beor hath said, and the man whose eyes are open hath said, He hath said, which heard the words of God, which saw the vision of the Almighty, falling into a trance, but having his eyes open. How goodly are thy tents, O Jacob, and thy tabernacles, O Israel! As the valleys are they spread forth, as gardens by the river's side, as the trees of line aloes, which the Lord hath planted, and as cedar trees beside the waters. He shall pour the water out of his buckets, and his seed shall be in many waters, and his king shall be higher than Agag, and his kingdom shall be exalted. God brought him forth out of Egypt. He hath, as it were, the strength of an unicorn. He shall eat up the nations his enemies, and shall break their bones, and pierce them through with his arrows. He couched, he lay down as a lion, and as a great lion. Who shall stir him up? Blessed is he that blesseth thee, and cursed is he that curseth thee.
And Balak's anger was kindled against Balaam, and he smote his hands together. And Balak said unto Balaam,
I called thee to curse mine enemies, and behold, thou hast altogether blessed them these 3 times. Therefore now flee thou to thy place. I thought to promote thee unto great honor, but lo, the Lord hath kept thee back from honor.
And Balaam said unto Balak,
Spake I not also to thy messengers, which thou sentest unto me, saying, If Balak would give me his house full of silver and gold, I cannot go beyond the commandment of the Lord to do either good or bad of mine own mind. But what the Lord saith, that will I speak. And now, behold, I go unto my people. Come therefore, and I will advertise thee what this people shall do to thy people in the latter days.
And he took up his parable and said,
Balaam the son of Beor hath said, and the man whose eyes are open hath said, he hath said, which heard the words of God, and knew the knowledge of the Most High, which saw the vision of the Almighty, falling into a trance, but having his eyes open, I shall see him, but not now. I shall behold him, but not nigh. There shall come a star out of Jacob, and a scepter shall rise out of Israel, and shall smite the corners of Moab, and destroy all the children of Sheth. And Edom shall be a possession. Seir also shall be a possession for his enemies, and Israel shall do valiantly. Out of Jacob shall come he that shall have dominion, and shall destroy him that remaineth of the city.
And when he looked on Amalek, he took up his parable and said,
Amalek was the first of the nations, but his latter end shall be that he perish forever.
And he looked on the Kenites, and took up his parable and said,
Strong is thy dwelling place, and thou puttest thy nest in a rock. Nevertheless, the Kenites shall be wasted until Asher shall carry thee away captive.
And he took up his parable and said,
Alas, who shall live when God doeth this? And ships shall come from the coast of Kittim, and shall afflict Asher, and shall afflict Eber, and he also shall perish forever.
And Balaam rose up and went and returned to his place, and Balak also went his way.
Great things he has done. I'm
to rise up with Benola. Rise up in praise, rise up in worship, rise up in our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of Jesus. A pleasant morning to you. It is a new day, and this is a day that the Lord has made. My name is Benola Glasgow, and it's Rise Up with Benola. Heard weekday mornings on this radio station from 5 a.m. to 6 a.m. and repeated on Chronicles Christian Radio at 8 a.m. And also you can listen to the past programs on my YouTube channel, Benola Glasgow. This morning, our meditation comes from the book of Numbers 22, 23, and 24, where we saw the story of the king of the Moabites, Balak, and the prophet Balaam, where Balak, the king, wanted to curse the children of Israel, and he did so through their own prophet, Balaam. Now we saw here, first of all, where Balak sent to Balaam and said, I want you to come and curse mine enemies. And Balak is the king of the Moabites. Now the Israelites didn't trouble him, but it says in the Bible that the children of Israel who came forth out of Egypt, they were a people who were great. And because there were many, Balak was afraid of them, and Balak sought to destroy them. And we saw where the Bible refers to it as rewards of divination, where the elders of Moab, they came unto Balaam with rewards of divination. So in other words, they were bribing him. They were giving him money in order to curse these people, and he was cursing his own people. All right. And we see here what we would call high level witchcraft or backbiting and so forth, because here the own prophet of Israel is being called upon to curse his own people. Now I want to reiterate here, as the scripture said, that whoever God bless, no one can curse. It doesn't matter if you like them or you don't like them. As long as God's hands are upon them, you cannot speak ill, you cannot curse them, whether by your words or whether you go by any obia or any witchcraft. It can't come to pass, and it wouldn't come to pass. And to be blessed means to be made holy or consecrated. And when God's hand is upon individuals or families or people, no demon, no devil in hell, no anything that is on this earth can come against them. And I want us to realize this. Now, Balaam the prophet, he went so far as being disobedient, where in the first place God told him, do not go, these people are blessed, they are blessed, do not go. The donkey that he rode on, and in those days they didn't have vehicles and the kind of technology that we have today, where you could just message somebody or you drive along quickly. So Balak had his messengers who he sent with the message and who brought back the message. And the mode of transportation, we realized that Balaam had, was a donkey. Now the donkey, when he was going on the way, when she was going on the way with Balaam on her back, saw an angel in the path. And the donkey knew that if she goes any further, that they would be destroyed. Now Balaam, his eyes were not open, so he didn't see the angel there with the sword. But God opened the mouth of the donkey. And when we think of this, we may laugh or look at it and it's become across something hilarious. But imagine, he was talking to a donkey, and I don't think he really realized what he was doing, because he was so focused on going to Balak. And then the donkey opened her mouth and spoke to Balaam. And Balaam, after God opened his eyes, realized what was happening and how he could have died, and God protected him. But did that stop Balaam from going to Balak? No, it didn't. He still proceeded to go to Balak. And we read of three different times where Balaam went to offer sacrifice unto God to hear what God's response was. Now, how could you go to the same God who has blessed the people to ask the same God to curse the people? Think about that a while. You are blessed. I am blessed. We are blessed with heaven's best. We are blessed and highly favored of the Most High God. The Most High God, the Almighty God, Jehovah, the one who created the sun, the one who created the mountains, the one who created this entire earth, the seas. When we look at his handiwork, the one who created the flowers, we haven't done any work for the flowers to grow or to bloom. We mold it, and sometimes we leave it, but it grows. And who is in control of all of that? Jehovah God, Yahweh, the God of the Israelites, the God of Moses. He is the one. He is the true and living God. And whoever he blesses, whomsoever he blesses, no one can curse. And Balak, the king, he spoke to Balaam and said, but I called you to curse these people three different times. I called you to curse them. And Balaam said, but I cannot curse them. And so Balak called him to curse them, but instead of cursing them, he blessed them. And as a result of this, Balak said, but you know what? Don't bless them and don't curse them. Now you see, if you're blessed of God, you're very well blessed. If you're blessed of God, you're very well blessed. Now we see also where Balak sought to promote, to honor Balaam. As long as he cursed the children of Israel. Who would you rather serve? It's better to be promoted by God than to be promoted by man. Because when man promotes you, they can remove you. But when God promotes you, you are well promoted. And one lesson I want to encourage us to learn from this today is to follow the ways of God. Follow the ways of God. Follow the paths of God. Now it would baffle me as to why Balaam would still go with King Balak when he knew that these people are blessed and they cannot be cursed. Now, I want to highlight a few verses that we can apply to our own selves. The first one, God is not a man that he should lie, neither the Son of Man that he should repent. Had he said it, and shall he not do it? Or had he spoken, and he not make it good? So whatsoever God has promised to you and I, God will fulfill it. He will bring it to pass, because he is God. He is your keeper. And the Word of God, the Holy Bible, when we speak this Word, when we speak the Word and hold God to His Word, He will come through. You are blessed. Confess blessing over you. Confess success. Speak success. Death and life are in the power of the tongue. And those who speak it will reap the rewards of it. And that's in Proverbs 18 and verse 21. And so, let us not curse who God has blessed. For the Word of God is yea or yes, and it is amen. In other words, it is done. It is so. And when we open the book, when we open the Bible and we read from the Bible, we see where God's promises are there. We see where God's protection is there for his children and for his people. Now we read of where the angel was in the way. Then the Lord opened the eyes of Balaam, and he saw the angel of the Lord standing in the way, and his sword drawn in his hand, and he bowed his head and fell flat on the face. There is an angel over you and I. We may not see them because our eyes are closed to them. And some persons may see them because their eyes are open, but confess the word, because God has given his angels charge over you and I to keep us in all our ways. And the psalmist tells us that they shall bear thee up in their hands, lest you dash your foot against a stone. Speak the word, believe the word of God. And that's the third verse. And so God would keep you. God would keep you. And it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter who. It doesn't matter who is against you. If God is for you, no one can be against you. No one can be against you. And we saw here where Balaam, he went to God, and when he was offering the sacrifices, he built 7 altars. And 7 represents the number of God. 7 represents the number of God. We see it many times in scripture where individuals would go before God 7 times, 7 times, 7. And God even asks us to forgive our enemies 70 times, 7 times. And so, no matter what you face today, know that God is with you. God is with you. Ensure, first of all, that you are in the will of God. And as long as you're in the will of God, and you know God is with you, he will direct your path. He will take care of you. You are blessed. You are blessed. You are blessed and highly favored of the Lord. I am blessed and highly favored of the Lord. I am blessed and highly favored of the Lord. I am blessed and highly favored of the Lord. And as we go through today, speak the word. Speak the word. Speak the word. And when you speak the word, we see that the word, the Bible said, the word of God is sharper than any two-edged sword. And the word, what you confess with your mouth, has the authority and the power to cut any demons and any spirits and any evil in your atmosphere and give you freedom to do your work one day at a time. Blessed be the name of Jesus. We worship and magnify our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. I'm going to share with you a bit of this selection by Glacier Robinson. I am blessed. Following which, we go into our Proverbs chapter 1, where we glean some wisdom from the wisest man who ever lived. I am blessed by Glacier.
Proverbs chapter 1.
The Proverbs of Solomon, the son of David, king of Israel. To know wisdom and instruction, to perceive the words of understanding, to receive the instruction of wisdom, justice and judgment and equity, to give subtlety to the simple, to the young man knowledge and discretion. A wise man will hear and will increase learning. and a man of understanding shall attain unto wise counsels. To understand a proverb and the interpretation, the words of the wise and their dark sayings. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge, but fools despise wisdom and instruction.
My son, hear the instruction of thy father, and forsake not the law of thy mother. For they shall be an ornament of grace unto thy head, and chains about thy neck. My son, if sinners entice thee, consent thou not. If they say,
Come with us, let us lay wait for blood, let us lurk privily for the innocent without cause. Let us swallow them up alive as the grave, and whole as those that go down into the pit. We shall find all precious substance, we shall fill our houses with spoil. Cast in thy lot among us, let us all have one purse.
My son, walk not thou in the way with them, refrain thy foot from their path. For their feet run to evil, and make haste to shed blood. Surely in vain the net is spread in the sight of any bird. And they lay wait for their own blood, they lurk privily for their own lives. So are the ways of everyone that is greedy of gain, which taketh away the life of the owners thereof.
Wisdom crieth without, she uttereth her voice in the streets. She crieth in the chief place of concourse, in the openings of the gates. In the city she uttereth her words, saying,
How long, ye simple ones, will ye love simplicity, and the scorners delight in their scorning, and fools hate knowledge? Turn you at my reproof. Behold, I will pour out my spirit unto you. I will make known my words unto you. Because I have called, and ye refused, I have stretched out my hand, and no man regarded. But ye have set at naught all my counsel, and would none of my reproof. I also will laugh at your calamity. I will mock when your fear cometh. When your fear cometh as desolation, and your destruction cometh as a whirlwind, when distress and anguish cometh upon you, then shall they call upon me, but I will not answer. They shall seek me early, but they shall not find me. For that they hated knowledge, and did not choose the fear of the Lord. They would none of my counsel, they despised all my reproof. Therefore shall they eat of the fruit of their own way, and be filled with their own devices. For the turning away of the simple shall slay them, and the prosperity of fools shall destroy them. But whoso hearkeneth unto me shall dwell safely, and shall be quiet from fear of evil.
And there we have Proverbs chapter 1, words of wisdom from the wisest man who ever lived. And so wisdom here is personified as a woman. And so in order for us to gain wisdom, we ought to have the fear of the Lord. For the fear of the Lord, the honor of God, the love of God, the respect of God, the respect and love and honor and trust of God will bring about knowledge, wisdom, and understanding. And so as we go forth into this new day, let us know that God is with us, God is on our side, and He will keep you in your ways. You are blessed and highly favored of the Most High God. And we access the Most High God through Jesus Christ, our Lord. And our theme verse here on Rise Up with Winola is Matthew, St. Matthew chapter 1 and verse 35, where it says, And rising up a great while before day, he departed and went into a solitary place, and there prayed. And so Jesus, when he walked this earth, he prayed unto his Father. And in order for us likewise as followers of Jesus to be successful and progressive in this earth, we ought to pray. And so we rise up in the morning, rise up and we pray unto our God. We spend time before His presence. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank You. Thank You, Lord God, for a brand new day. This is the day that You have made, and we rejoice and we are glad in it. Thank You, Lord, for Your goodness. Thank You, Lord, for Your blessings. Thank You for the breath of life. Thank You for providing our every need. Lord, You are great. Lord, You are good. And so we worship You, O God. We honor Your name. thank you, Lord God, that you have blessed us. And we are blessed in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. Lord God, help us to read your word. Help us to spend time in your word. To meditate upon your word. In Joshua 1:9, we read of where it says here, this book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou shalt meditate in it day and night, and therein we'll find good success. Lord, we want your good success. We want your good blessings, O God. And so we seek your word. We spend time in your presence. We read and understand and gain wisdom to know what and how we should live in the earth. Lord, cover us under your blood. Direct our steps as we face a new day, a new month, as we continue to go through this year. Thank you for all your blessings on us. In Jesus' name, I pray with thanksgiving. Amen. Hallelujah. We worship and magnify the true and living God. A pleasant day to you, and I pray that as you go forward today, that the blessings of the Most High God would overshadow you, would give you wisdom, understanding, and most of all, peace. Peace. The peace of God in this troublesome and chaotic world. The peace of God be upon you. Hallelujah. And now I'll be sharing this selection from our friend over in Barbados, Mr. Henry John. And as you go forth, remember, it's step by step. Step by step. One day at a time. 1 minute at a time. 1 hour at a time. God is with you. And he will direct your step.
Ain't gotta be a big one. Moving step by step, little by little.
Step by step, 1 minute at a time. You've been listening to Rise Up with Fenola, heard weekday mornings, Monday to Friday, from 5 a.m. to 6 a.m., where we lift up the name of Jesus, where we rise up in praise, rise up in worship, rise up in Jesus. Thank you for listening, and do join me again in the morning in the will of the Lord for another edition. May the blessings of God be upon you today and always. May you walk in His pathways of blessing. And may you know and confess that you are blessed and highly favored of the Lord. God bless you and stay sweet in our Lord and our Savior, Jesus Christ.
On the rise.